I have these things because I have them for my vehicles. And if you take that and recycle it, then I'm gonna have to go buy another one to put on my vehicle.
I just want you to think about, in 12 days, the city's gonna do this for you.
Why did I go out and spend money for this stuff just so you can deprive me of it?
I'm not trying to deprive you of it.
I bought these things to put on my vehicle.
I know, but do you have the health to put it on your vehicle?
Don't touch the blue snowblower. It's not mine. It doesn't belong to me.
He got irate. He said he had plans for all these things, that we were ruining his life. And unfortunately, he's not realizing that he's ruining his own life.
Those are going to my new place.
Okay. How about this grill to this Dodge right here?
Yeah, that goes to...
Recycle?
Why did I even bother to save anything when it's all just gonna get taken away from me?
Well,
it's not, it's gonna be reused.
It's gonna be reused, that's the
problem. It's gonna be reused? Yeah, I was gonna reuse it.
I know, but you don't have much time. I'm just trying to be the voice of reason. I'm very concerned that as much as we want to help Jeff, he's not ready for help at this point.
So this is from May. Are you gonna actually go through this now that it's already a month and a half old?
Doesn't matter what I say. Go ahead, recycle it.
Well, I just think we have a lot of stuff that
so
I don't
what?
Think... I don't know, that you're never going to end up going through. That's the only point we're trying to get to. So this is
stay
stuff
out
on
of that.
Health. Okay? And that's
don't
the same...
put it with that other stuff.
Okay, it's the same stuff.
No, it is not. That's a mailer that I just received with important things inside of it.
Okay, it's labeled the same thing, bone health and life health. I know, it's just labeled the same. I won't
yeah,
put it together.
Yeah, it's called duplicates, and it's to give out to customers. Put it back in the box.
Well, no, we're gonna
put
finish...
Put it back in the box, now!
Jeff, we're gonna finish...
When Jeff threatened the organizer, I was really worried about everybody's safety. If he's gonna start threatening people, we need to shut this down.
Jeff, you're the rest of it.
You were threatening her.
I'm getting... threatened here, and I'm getting furious.
He threatened.
Do you want to be done for the day?
You were one of the ones that told me something wouldn't be done unless I said it was okay. What's happening here?
I don't think you can do this anymore. Do you want to stop?
We're okay to stop.
I think we're gonna stop.
While I was talking to Jeff on the tarp about how he was treating the organizer, his daughter Jen just broke down crying. This was just too much for her.
All we're trying to do is help you. What would you like us to do?
How does it help me when I ask?
It doesn't matter.
Times?
Well, we're done with that. Moving forward, what do you want us to do?
Can I interrupt for just a minute?
Yeah.
Genevieve, Dad, she wants to say something to you.
I know most of this stuff is, like, really important to you.
Mm-hmm.
But I can't live with a whole bunch of stuff at the new house. It's too small.
Can you look at it?
I can't live with all this stuff.
How does it affect you? Tell him how it affects you.
Well, I don't like how he's yelling at everyone because they're trying to help.
Well, I don't like the way I'm being pressured and forced to do things that are very uncomfortable for me.
I know how hard it is for you to get rid of stuff, but think of our children. Think of our daughter. I've been worried about her for the past 18
Fine.
Years.
Take her with you then.
It made my heart sink. In that moment, it didn't seem like he cared about me at all.
What's more important to you?
Your daughter?
All this? Or this? She's crying out to you. I'll stay here until it gets done, okay? Do you want to live by yourself in your house without your daughter?
Yeah.
No, you don't. You don't. You love your daughter. You love
happy
your daughter.
Happy now?
No, you love your daughter.
What you said, Jeff. Yeah.
Do you really want to choose your stuff over your daughter?
You know what? This is
Jeff. Jeff. Right here. Hey, right here. Relax. Jeff's having a breakdown. And he needs to realize that it's either the junk or his daughter, because his daughter's pretty much given him an ultimatum that she can't live with it anymore. Come on, man.
You know, I'm
Come
fed on. Up with this.
No, you're...
I am.
Chris...
You people need to give me a break.
All right, why don't you go take a break, all right?
Throughout this whole process, I don't think Jeff really gets how much his hoarding affects himself and how much it affects other people.
I just felt my heart drop that he didn't want me to live with him.
And I think it, you know, let him know it hurt your feelings. Yeah, that hurt real bad. So he doesn't think he can just get away with talking to you like that. Because I think he talks off the top of his head and he doesn't realize the kinds of things he's saying to people.
Mm-hmm. Hi there.
I didn't really like how everything was falling apart. It was just, I didn't know it was gonna be this hard.
Bear with me through this. We'll get through it. I know it's hard and it's hard to see, but it's hard on me too. You know, it's not that those things are more valuable or worth more than you are by any sense of the word, because you're the most important thing in my life. But I love you dearly. So, anyway, we'll get through this, all right?
Even though Jeff didn't get much accomplished in terms of letting go of his belongings, maybe he started to realize how his hoard is affecting his kids. Maybe that was the gem that we had today.
While progress was slow to begin with on haul away day, in the last 2 months, Jeff has managed to fulfill his obligation of clearing the property, both inside and out.
I received an extension of a month to enable me to get the rest of my possessions off the property by the purchaser. I spent basically almost night and day for about 2 months doing everything necessary to facilitate the move from where I was living to where I'm living now.
But while the old property is nearly ready for the new owners, it remains to be seen if Jeff has been able to conquer his compulsion and begin a new life devoid of stuff. Today, Jeff's friend Shari has driven 40 miles north from Lake Tahoe to see Jeff's new home for the first time.
I'm just worried that Jeff hasn't completely learned how unnecessary some of these things are. If the outside is any indication of how Jeff is living, I'm a little concerned about what the inside's gonna look like. I have a feeling it's gonna be really full. It's frightening how much stuff is out here. It's scary what he didn't get rid of. It feels like not only the stuff from the old house got dropped here, but it just seems like there's more.
Come on in.
Hey.
Hi, Shari.
Hey, you got a real room.
Yeah.
This is cool. This is not bad. This is a lot better than your previous home.
Yeah. Well, come on in. Let's take a look here.
Thanks.
This, of course, is our living room.
This is great.
Our primary living area.
Yeah.
And it's nice.
Yeah. I was actually kind of surprised when I walked into Jeff's home today. There's a lot less stuff inside than in his old home and the outside here. Very cool.
Yeah, and we've got, there's a built-in china cabinet here, which is real nice.
Oh, great.
And I get to put all my goodies on display.
You know, you've got very few boxes. Looks like you're trying to keep things out of the house itself.
Well, most of the stuff that's on the porch is stuff I took out of here because it didn't belong in here anyway, and there's no need for it to be in here.
I think this is really, really good. Because when I looked outside, I was a little worried. I'm seeing a change in Jeff. And I think the emotional problems that he went through with Jen has made him realize that his kids are more important than his stuff.
I don't think my dad cares more about his stuff than me. Now he realizes that I'm more important than just stuff laying around.